tonight. That's cool. I'm kind of alive too. I don't really know what to draw, so I'm just going for it. Oh, it has? Is it, like, trying to do an update or something? Oh, no. I can't draw the Mona Lisa. Out of memory. Ah. Your canvas is probably too big. That's the problem that I had experienced with Paint Tool Sai after a while, and why I ended up switching over to Clip Studio Paint. Were you trying to paint something big? Well, but like, was your canvas very big? Or was it sort of like the normal size canvas you were trying to use? Because that's what I found on like my old programs when they were complaining about memory issues. That seems quite huge. You should change it into, like inches or something that, you know more. Like, instead of pixels. Like, I mean, America uses inches, but I think you use, like, centimeters or something. Because my guess is it's, I think that's like something, it's greater than 100 inches on one side, at least in US, I think. Well, unless you're trying to print it really big, you could just reduce the overall size of the canvas and then change the size of the lettering to match. Hi, Final Summoner. I'm doing okay. I really don't know what I'm drawing, but I'm just trying to, like, play with it. And if I get bored mushing around the color here, I have some line art that I can get to. Ruin the precision. Are you super far into the drawing at this point? Basic stuff in art? Like, what kind of basic stuff would you like to learn? Is it your first time adding lettering? Oh, making your own lettering. Can you shrink the lettering? Even if it's on like a different layer and you drew it all yourself, you should be able to shrink it. Okay. Well, if you ever need help with something, I can always try to help. Did I get up to much today? I applied for like 3 jobs today, and that's sort of what I did with my day. Well, unfortunately, I don't think you're gonna see anything super professional tonight. I'm really just playing around, with sort of a style I'm not familiar with. I've been trying out sort of new styles and ways of making every night recently, so unfortunately, I have no guarantees about whatever this will look like later. Yeah, human resource jobs. Not really playing, unfortunately. But doing what I could. We are kind of on an adventure. I didn't know what I was going to draw tonight, and I didn't know how I would do it. So we're just starting here, and we'll see where it ends up. Oh, there it is. did I even do? Frustrating. The panels on the side panel were going a little crazy, and I don't know why they started doing that, unfortunately. So now there's like a weird box. It's weird. So it's probably gonna look super janky for a long time. No, I don't think so. I wasn't setting out with anyone in mind. Anyway, I don't expect any of this to be any good, unfortunately. Yeah. Sometimes I have a plan or I come in with some line art. I have some line art prepared, so if people get bored of this, I can always do line art. Thank you. Well, I'm interested to see how it turns out, too. Yeah, I'm just trying out different ways of making. And I haven't tried this way before. So we'll see if it's any good. I know you haven't been to one of these before of mine, so it was really nice for you to come along, Summoner. I just hope that it isn't too disappointing. Yeah, the hardest part is often getting started, so that's why I've started streaming. Not like every night, but most nights. I probably would try every night if I didn't get so tired. If you want to talk about anything, I'm always here. Well, maybe you're getting used to not sleeping. Although I don't know if that's a good thing to get used to. Enjoy different art styles too. Like, a lot of my art has been just sort of one style, and I was just really interested in trying new things, and I know that it always doesn't look good on the first try or stuff like that, so I really want to be open-minded about it all. It's going, I guess. Thank you. If you like seeing a new style, I guess it's all new for us, too. Do I plan to move anywhere? Unless I get a job, probably not. I live with my parents currently, but it wasn't always like that. I lived with, Kraka for a long time, my boyfriend, and I'd like to get back to him soon, but now's just really not a very good time. I had moved out in like mid-October, and in hopes to find a job here so that we could move, and it just didn't pan out very well because I was trying to get in the museum field and it just really wasn't working. So and then when the pandemic hit, it went really bad, and I just saw a statistic come through the Instagram feed that the museums are expecting to maybe see like a third of all places, of all museums and cultural sites close this year due to the pandemic. So it really wasn't the best sort of goal for us anymore to try to get me into that field. It was already so competitive. So, I don't know. Yeah, so then I switched over to, maybe try some digital, like, graphic design, and I had gotten a certificate in it and stuff, and, you know, I've been doing graphic art for a long time, but I've also been doing traditional art for longer, But I just decided I maybe don't want to do digital art for a living. So I switched over to HR, human resources, because I'm good with people and it would probably be good. And I'm just trying to finish schooling for that. Just sort of online at home, I'm doing a certificate program to do HR stuff. And so that's sort of what I'm doing right now. Although it's not terribly, I don't know. I mean, it's interesting, yes, but also it's kind of boring. Let's see. Thanks. Yeah, right now it's just kind of difficult, and I'm trying not to get my hopes up too high about anything, but like I said, I applied to 3 jobs today, and, you know, it'll be, I probably applied to, you know, 75, 100 jobs so far, and still no luck, although I don't think it's for lack of being qualified. I think there's just a ton of competition right now. But the reason why we chose HR is because I'll probably be good at it, and also because it's almost always hiring. It's one of the things that's sort of like taxes, where people tend to need it. Tend to always need it, so... Well, I wouldn't feel too saddened. I mean, it's not really a great time for anything right now. So, I wouldn't worry about me too much, and I'm sure that eventually I'll find something, but usually when it would have taken, like, 100 tries or 100 job applications, to get a job, now it's more like 300. So, just goes up, it seems, but it's alright. Night, Lucy. Have a good evening. Yeah, eventually something will happen. And in the meantime, you know, I started getting back into this drawing stuff, and Cracker has mentioned that it's made me a much happier person, so that's good. Now, see here, Retro, I know that you don't like to use the ball and joint bit, but that's sort of how I make elbows and wrists and stuff and know where to bend them. I would really recommend it to you. We'll give her like a stick of some sort. Oh, thanks. I don't get like, I don't know if I get sad, I just get depressed. And then I get sad, I guess. And I had like, I don't know, I had a breakdown like a couple months ago before the pandemic, and my friends were able to put me back together, so that's good. Well, I will admit it's a little hard to tell what's going on here. I assume melt is like a British term because I've heard you use it before, but it's not used in America, it seems. Not in the way that I think you're using it. Oh, I see. I think this is gonna get really messy. But hopefully it's not too bad. Well, basically I've merged all of the lines and the color together here, so I imagine it's going to get a little smushy before it gets better. I don't know if I like this method that much. Not a whole lot of structure going on here. My oldest memory? Probably when I dressed up as a cow for Halloween one time when I was super, super young. I probably was maybe 3 or something. And there was this lady who I guess was dressed up as a Dalmatian. Or, well, she was dressed up as a cow and I was dressed up as a Dalmatian. And she thought that I was a baby cow. Maybe not the most riveting of stories, but there you go. Smudgy, smudgy, smudgy everywhere. Yeah, get that free candy. Oh my. That's kind of fun. Do you remember as being dressed up as anything? Retro? Yeah, Halloween costumes are kind of difficult. I used to make mine and my sister's. Sorry, I wasn't paying attention. What's a difficult, industry? Oh, cosplaying. Yeah. I imagine that it's really expensive. It really is, but some people are really amazing at it. I don't know if I'd ever cosplay even if I had the money to do so. Could be fun, but I'm just not sure about it. Yeah, inconvenient clothes is hard. Hi, Masio. How are you doing? Well, sometimes they're inside and they're not 100-degree heat. Or are all the cons that you've been to outside or know of? Thank you. No problem. Don't worry about it, Maso. You do you. I'm just gonna be here. Oh, so they stick the cosplayers outside. All the ones that I've seen, and I've only seen a few, have always been inside. Well, usually for me, or at least when I've seen them, they haven't been in a showroom, but you can take them sort of out in like Artist Alley or something, or there was like a little area where there wasn't like any booths where people would pose for pictures sometimes. That hand's weird. Uh-oh, I think it's getting rainy. Oh, hi, Nico. How are you doing? I'm doing okay. I'm trying something new again. However, I don't know how it's working out. We're gonna see. And I just heard thunder, so hopefully I won't be shut out. Why don't I use folders? Too much effort. I don't know. It's probably my best answer. No problem, Masio. Why are you salty? Uh-oh, because Neko's here and it's like 6 a.m. Well, that's not great. Oh, it's so early for everyone. Everyone needs more sleep than they're getting. Okay, see you soon, Masio. The shadowing effect, you think, is pretty cool? It's coming along. I guess it was not more than a smudge earlier, so it definitely is coming along. Sleep was sold to the French in the Recession. Uh-oh. Just sort of forcing things to come together here. Okay. I'm glad that you think it looks like a watercolor or an oil painting. It is sort of the same technique where it's sort of all, it's all together and you just sort of push it around. Or you push color around. Thank you. Well, I don't know how good this is. It's just, I haven't done this before. So we're just sort of winging it. Hi, Sundance Kid. Oh, I'm glad that you think it's cute. Nice to see you. Yeah. I haven't seen you around before, but I'm relatively new to streaming. I'm just trying to teach myself something new on these live streams that I keep doing. And we're just trying to get this hand to form properly. Or at least in a way that makes sense. That's all I can hope for, really. With the drawing element in play. Oh, like in oil paintings? Actually, oil paintings don't dry out very fast at all. It can take months and months for it to dry out. And it remains what's called open. And that means that it's still changeable. Unlike acrylic, which actually dries really fast, but it's super opaque so that you can always go over it. If you don't like it, so. Oh, I'm moving my settings. Oy. Hands really are not my forte, so sorry if this takes a while. Doesn't look quite right. Aww. Well, we'll get there eventually. I think it's too low. Let me try moving it. There we go. I think it was just a little low. Anyway, for not knowing at all where I was going to go with this, it is turning out relatively okay, which I'm pleased with. Oh, it did? Maybe I had different watercolor or different oil paints than you did, because mine always took ridiculously long to dry, and I live out in the desert, and it was just like months. But I never stuck it outside. Yeah, the hand seems better now that I moved it up and stuff. I think that there's something wrong with your Winsor & Newton oil paints, because they really should not be coming to you dry and crusty like they are. When I work, you might have gotten just old ones. When I worked at a craft store, and we sold Winsor & Newton stuff, sometimes people would come back and the product was all dried out, and it really isn't supposed to be that way. Maybe it wasn't a very popular item. Well, that's because the white paint had oil. Technically, they're all supposed to have oil in them. first experience. I had gotten some water-soluble oil paints at a super discount at a like on sale at a school that I was visiting for college, like to see if I wanted to go to that college. And when I brought them back home, they were super crusty and they would not reconstitute, and it was terrible. Yeah, oil paintings are really difficult, in my opinion, having tried a lot of mediums. Anyway, if you ever wanted to try, like, this sort of technique retro, I know that, Karita has a brush function that's almost exactly like this one, if not better. So you could always try it like this, because it is similar, in look to oil, if that's something that you're interested in. See you in a bit. What is the hardest format? Oh yeah, it's looking better. I'm getting really pleased with how it's looking. What do you mean, format? Oh, art medium. I've tried a lot. Let me try to think about it. Hardest art medium that I've done. You know, woodblock carving, pretty difficult, just because it requires a lot of muscle. That might have been the hardest. Or, like, etching. Etching was very time intensive. Worthwhile, but took forever. Like with the acid baths and stuff. Kinda dangerous too. Ooh, sculpture. I didn't really take like sculpture in like marble. I could have, but I ended up not. I ended up just taking general sculpture because I wasn't that into it. And in general sculpture, I just made sculptures out of like debris and stuff, covered in paper mache or whatever to get it to look like how we want it to look. We did have a marble sculpture sort of class. If you got super advanced in it, the school would get you marble and you could do marble block, but it just wasn't ever for me. I ended up actually doing something that the school didn't offer at the time. They do now, and it's probably because of what I did. Fabric arts, so that giant dress that I made was like my final project, and I just would use the resources at home. I did visit like the school's like theater department and stuff, but it was really quite a trek it was too far away to get any good instruction from here to there, if that makes any sense. What did I make in sculpture? Oh, just whatever I kind of wanted. So I made this great shoe out of just paper. Looked like a real shoe afterwards. That was very cool. I made, I had a group project where I made a brain on a book on a pedestal. With apps flying out it. That was sort of like a group effort. One, me and this other girl. And we put it together, just sort of paper mache'd it and stuff. It was kind of interesting. And then, there was definitely one where I made that looked like me. That one was alright. I've had some here and there over the years. Sculpture was never anything that I really wanted to get super into. Of what I ended up doing at school that I ended up investing in that they actually offered was probably printmaking. Fabric art's not too difficult to store. You just sort of fold it up and shove it in a bin. It's what I did anyway. It's not super archival or anything, but as long as the moths don't get to it, it should be fine. It's never too late if you wanted to go back to art school eventually. Like, you're at university, aren't you? Could you transfer into an art school? Or do they not do transfers in the UK? For what it's worth, I didn't go to an art school either. I went to a liberal arts college. If that makes any difference to you. So a liberal arts school teaches all of the subjects, like history, math, science. You could major in like business, you could major in English, that type of thing, versus an art school where you just learn art. Although you never just learn art, but you know, it's the main focus. At least in America, art schools cost tremendously more than liberal arts schools. Yeah. So, like, I didn't want to limit myself, but also it was too expensive. There are, like, sometimes hundreds of thousands of dollars to go per semester, and my family was not about to pay that, and I was not about to pay that in debt, so... So I just sort of went to like a pretty good, high-rated liberal arts college and got an art degree there, because they still offered art, but not like they would offer at like CalArts or Rhode Island School of Design or, you know, Parsons School of Fashion in New York. Not like that, but still very good, still very respectable. Yeah, I had done community college a little bit, and I'm actually doing a little bit of community college now. It's much more affordable, and tends to be just as good sometimes. Oh, community college. Interesting. Yeah, you might be going to an equivalent of a community college. That's not to say you don't have good teachers or anything. Yeah, community college is actually very good. And it has received a little bit of stigma, but I think a lot of that stigma is going away, especially due to COVID. I'm getting my continuing education at, I guess not at community college, but at our state school, and my sister's doing community college classes. Yeah, that's usually true. But it's unfortunate when employers think that way too. But actually, once you start getting work experience, I don't think anyone actually cares anymore about your schooling. Like, Like, they'll probably make sure that it's accredited and that you did actually go, but I don't think anyone actually cares. Oh, that's cool. Like a technical role. Did you go, like a trade? Did you do, like, trade school? Where did my eraser go? Oh, here it is. An online master's program? It's kind of cool. Let's see. Cybersecurity? Oh, that's really cool. Ooh, ethical hacking. That's fun. That's cool. I don't know if I remember that. Since I've been doing watercolor, it's really unusual to find anyone else who does watercolor, and I tend to have my own set then. Yeah, some people are very bad with keeping art supplies nice. A lot of people don't have any respect for it, it seems. glad you think it looks cool. People think it looks good. I was really not sure how it would turn out before, so I'm actually very pleased. glad that you all think it looks cool. Yeah, she's sort of sweeping up something. Weird. Okay. Stuck on the shadow effects. Glad they're looking good though. think that looks pretty good. I'll call it a day. On this one, yeah. That you think it's really nice. I'm pleased. I'm glad that you think it looks good. Well, I think I might call it a night then. I finished the one thing, and then the thing that I have to save, I can save for another time. Everyone has a good night. I'm glad that you were here to watch me make this. I know that it was a little odd at first, but I think it turned out well. So I'm pleased. Alright. Thanks for coming by. Yeah, no problem. Thank you for coming. I know I haven't seen you before, but hopefully it wasn't too boring and that you had a nice time. But yeah, I hope you guys have a nice evening, and I'll see you all later. Bye!